My name is Professor Adele Holloway, and I'm the Associate Head Learning and Teaching for the Tasmanian School of Medicine. And I'm actually a molecular biologist, so I'm interested in DNA and how DNA works. Okay, come through. Sometimes it's amazing, isn't it, how sometimes the labs have the best views. I've been Associate Head Learning and Teaching for about 5 years in the School of Medicine, but I've been working in the school for probably almost 20 years, so quite a long time in the school. So this is our main lecture theatre, and so can fit, I think, 200 students in here. Yeah, so one of the advantages for international students in our medical school, it is a quite small medical school, so students do get treated as individuals in our school, and so a very personalised experience. And also Tasmania is small, and so it's relatively easy to get around. You can live close to the university where you're studying and the hospitals where you're working. It's also for students who are interested in the environment and outdoors. It's a really nice place to live as well. One of the other things is that Tasmania is rural and regional, so sometimes there are advantages for people who are looking for visas and things like that of living in those types of parts of Australia. So obviously we don't have any students in at the moment, but this is one of our main teaching labs. So we've got three labs like this. This one we call the wet lab. There's one called the dry lab, which has our, which we look at specimens a little bit more. So this is used for things like microbiology and biochemistry and things like that, whole sets of microscopes in this room. So our course just moved to a new course, which is a Bachelor of Medical Science and Doctor of Medicine, so what we call an MD program. And so it's still 5 years. We still take in students who are year 12 leavers, undergraduate degree, but students will come out with that master's level qualification. And so 2023 was the first year of that program, and so we're rolling out that program. So what that means is students during their degree also will have access to what we call a professional project. So that might be a research experience or some other experience. A lot of students will do a research experience during their medical course. I guess one of our specialties is around rural medicine, and so we are a rural and regional medical school, and so our students do get placements in rural areas. The other thing, I guess, that's a bit specialised about our school is that this building, years 1 to 3 are based in, also houses the Menzies Research Institute. So we're very closely aligned with that research institute, and that particularly has specialties in neuroscience and in genetics and in areas like that. So that's another strength of our medical school, our close location with a research institute. We do a lot of genetic research, and so looking at genetic basis of disease and particularly cancers, and Tasmania is a really good place to do that because, you know, we have families in Tasmania where we can go back like 4 or 5 generations and actually, you know, identify these huge families to work on. And the other thing that our researchers also are working on, obviously, is the Tasmanian devil facial tumour disease. So obviously not a human cancer, but really, you know, dear to all of us. And so the way it's set up is we have these little specialist labs. So this is a gel running facility, and the next one is our cell culture facility. And then we have our big general labs. All the students just ran away. So yeah, this is one of our big research areas. And so this is the research lab. So actually the other thing I should have mentioned was the Wiking Dementia Research Education Centre. So they very much specialise in neuroscience and dementia, and they're located in this building too. We have a few Japanese students in the course, and I think that they're doing well, and from what I've heard, I've interacted with one of them recently, and they're enjoying their time with us. Of some of the medical students who have also done research during their degrees, and you know, for example, we have got a local medical student who became a Rhodes Scholar, so went and did their PhD in the UK and had an interest in neuroscience. So those kinds of opportunities are also available to students studying with us. So there are lots of those kinds of opportunities.